Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial series. In this session, we'll be working with some basic functions in SQL. So we'll look at the min function, max function, count function, sum function, and average function. Let's start with the min function. The min function gives the smallest value in a column. Let's look at the syntax. First, we give in the select keyword. Then we give the min function, and inside the parenthesis, we specify the name of that column from which we're supposed to find the minimum value. So I want to extract the age of the youngest employee of the company. So this would be the command for that. Select, and then I'll use the min function and then pass in the column, which would be eh. I'll use the from keyword and then give in the name of the table, which would be employee. So the total command is select minimum of eh from employee. I'll hit execute. So we see that the minimum age in the table is 21. Similarly, if I wanted to extract the salary of that employee, who would get the least salary? So the command would be select min, and instead of eh, it would be esalary from employee. So the salary of the employee who earns the least is $73,000. Then we have the max function. The max function gives the largest value in a column. Here again, we give in the select keyword, following which we give the max function, and inside the function, we specify the name of the column from which we're supposed to get the maximum value. Now I'd want to extract the maximum age and maximum salary from this table. So this would be the command for that. Select, and I will start off by extracting the maximum age. Inside the max function, I will pass in the column, which is e of age. And then I'll use the from keyword and then give in the name of the table, which is employee. So the maximum age of an employee is 45. Similarly, I want to find out the maximum salary. So that would be E salary from employee. Execute. So the maximum salary is $159,000. Then there's a count function. So the count function returns the number of rows that match a specified criteria. That is, if we wanted to find out the number of male and female employees in a company, then we can use the count function. Let's look at the syntax. So after the select keyword, you'll use the count function and give in an asterisk inside the parenthesis. Then you'll give the table name, and finally you'll use the where clause to give the condition. So let's use this count function to get the count of number of male and female employees. So I'll start off by getting the count of number of male employees. So select, I will use the count function, and inside the count function, I will pass in the asterisk symbol. After which, I'll use the from keyword and then give in the name of the table, which would be employee. Then using the where clause, I will give in the condition. So I'd want the count of all of the male employees. So E of gender should be equal to male. Let me see, what do we get. So there are 4 male employees in total. Similarly, if I wanted to get the count of all the female employees, the command would be select count of star from employee where E gender equals female, right? So this would be the only difference. I'll hit execute. So I get 2. So there are 2 female employees in the entire organization. Then we have the sum function. So the sum function would give you the total sum of a numeric column. And this is the syntax. So here similarly, we will give in the sum function after the select keyword and give the column name inside the parenthesis. So I'd want to get the total sum of salaries of all of the employees, right? So the sum of salaries of all of the employees. Select, and then I'll use the sum function, and then I'll pass in the column, which would be E salary from the name of the table, which is employee. So the total salary of all of the employees included is $644,000 per annum. And finally, we have the average function. So the average function gives us the average value of a numeric column. And the syntax is same as the rest. So we'll give in the average function after the select keyword and give the column name inside the parenthesis. So this time I'd want to get the average age of all of the employees. So select, and then I will use the AVG function and then give in the column, which would be EH from the name of the table, which is employee. So the average age of all of the employees is 30. So guys, these were some of the aggregate functions in SQL. In the next session, we'll work with the order by clause. So thanks for attending this session. Let's meet in the next class.